Okay, the first question, for our today's agenda will be why AWS and why DevOps. Okay, and then later on we'll be seeing some of the AWS services, and then we'll be creating one EC2 instance and then building a server, and the last of our session will be having a question answer session, okay, where you can guys can ask me, okay, questions related to our stuff. Okay, don't hesitate to ask any kind of question. Okay, and then for our first question, why AWS? Okay, as you can see this picture over here, okay, so if I need to, okay, have an infrastructure for my company, if I need to have a setup for my company, if I need to run a servers for my company, this is how it will look like, right? So this was the previous generation architecture. Okay, now rather than creating servers in this environment, okay, I want to create the servers in cloud. Okay, so who is my cloud provider? AWS is my cloud provider. So if you see this picture over here, you might be thinking that, okay, it's so much jump pulled over here. Do we actually need to maintain these many servers, and running these many servers would be a hazard task for us? Okay, would be a difficult task for us, and you require, okay, bunch of team. You require network engineers, you require IT engineers, okay, and you require server maintenance engineers, okay. So you require a lot of teams. So avoiding those many members, avoiding those many teams is where you will be running all these servers on AWS cloud. Okay, now your dashboard will not look like this, which is there in the picture. Okay, now how it will be looking like this. So this is how it is much simplified over here. Okay, over here in this picture you are running around 100 of servers. Okay, might be 1000 servers. Now you will feel, you will be appearing those 1000 servers, 100 servers will be appearing over here on this dashboard. Okay, so what is this dashboard? This is my AWS dashboard. This is my cloud dashboard. Okay, and as I've told you, these are the list of services provided by AWS. Okay, there is a compute service, there is a storage service, there is a data service. So what is the meaning of a service? What is AWS is trying to give to us actually? Okay, so AWS is trying to give us some facilities. Okay, rather than creating your servers physically, rather than running your applications physically on your office premises, what AWS is doing, AWS is providing you all these facilities on their cloud, on their infrastructure. Okay, so to access that infrastructure, this is the dashboard. Okay, so you can create compute machines, which means servers, you can create storage. Okay, ample amount of storage, you will never be exhausted with the storage over here. They are also giving you facility for creating a database. Okay, you can create networks, you can create user creations. Okay, so a lot of services are there. Okay, now on the right side of your screen, you might be seeing there is a username and into which region I have been logged into. Okay, so again, as this is a cloud environment, AWS is hosting this cloud from these many data centers. So the city names which you see on the right side of your screen are actually the data centers on which AWS is hosting their servers. Okay, now you can create your servers, or you can, okay, deploy your application in any of these regions which are spread across the globe. Okay, currently I have logged into North Virginia region, which is a US region. Okay, and if you observe onto this dashboard, currently you can see there are zero machines, zero running instances. Everything is quite zero over here. Okay, so I have made it zero because this is our very first beginning step of the session. Okay, so almost everything is zero. Okay, so for our today's session, our first task. Okay, so this is our first task. Okay, our first task would be, okay, I want you people to, okay, create a server over here in cloud. Okay, create a server or create a machine over here in cloud with your first step or first task. Okay, so how to create a server? Okay, let us go ahead in our session and let us see, okay, how to create a server. Okay, for creating a server, you have an option over here as launch instance. The blue button which you see over here on the screen is for launch instance, is for creating a server. Okay. Now, if I click on launch instance, okay, I will be redirected to this screen. And on this screen, if you see on the top of the screen, there are 7 steps given to me. Okay. So these are step 1, step 2, step 3, up to 7 steps are given to me. Okay. So I would like to tell one thing over here is, okay, whatever kind of server or machine you will be trying to create for your environment or for your infrastructure, these 7 steps would be universally common on, okay, on this cloud platform. Okay, so either you might be creating a Windows server, either you might be creating a Linux server, either you might be creating a Red Hat, SUSE, Linux, okay, whatever it may be the flavor of your machine, okay, these 7 steps will be remaining, okay, common or universally common for us. Okay, and let us have a breakdown of what will happen at each step, okay, from step 1 to step 7. Okay, so let us note down these steps over here. So now what I'm going to do is I'm proceeding on to my step 1. Okay, so let us see what is happening at step 1. So what is asking me to do on step 1 is asking me to please choose an AMI. Okay, where AMI stands for Amazon Machine Image. Okay, so in simple terms, if I want to tell you what is an AMI, okay, AMI is nothing but my machine operating system or my the flavor of operating system on which I want to create a server. Okay, suppose if you want to create a Linux machine, this is your Linux image flavor, first one. Okay, if you want to create a Red Hat machine, this is your Red Hat image. Okay, and if you want to create a Windows machine, this is your Windows image. So all these images are being given by AWS for us. All these images are licensed and trademarked by AWS. You don't need to pay anything extra for these operating systems. Okay, everything is being given to you on a free trial mode. Okay, so basically what we are doing at step 1, we are selecting machine operating system. Okay, what we are doing at step 1, selecting, okay, operating system or OS of my machine. Okay, that is what I am doing at step 1. Okay, so for this session, I am selecting a Windows server first. Later on, we will be creating a Linux server as well. Okay, selected. Now, we have moved to step 2. Okay, so what is step 2? Step 2, what is asking us to do? Is asking us to please choose an instance type. Okay, so basically what is asking us to choose is my machine RAM. If you see on the fourth column of this table, if you see over here, there are list of RAM configurations being given. Okay, so basically we require for creating a machine, okay, we require operating system, we require RAM, we require storage, we require hard disk, volume, everything, right? So we are selecting each one of those in every one of these steps. Okay, the second step, we are choosing instance type, nothing but my machine RAM. The memory which is asking over here, is showing over here, is the size of my RAM, the configuration of my RAM. So starting from 1 GB, if I scroll down, I have 8 GB, I have been given with 16 GB, I have been given with 32 GB. Okay, if I scroll down, the maximum RAM which you can pick for a single machine is 12,288 GB of RAM. That is what AWS is providing to us. It is a very huge size, it is a very huge RAM which will be given to your machine. So it will be quite impossible if we try to give this physically on a machine. It will be difficult. I will not say impossible, but it will be difficult and it will cost us a lot. But over here in AWS, on a single machine, you can easily have around 12,000 gigs of RAM. Or else 9,000 gigs of RAM is also given. We have 4,000 gigs of RAM, 6,000 gigs of RAM. So configuration wise, okay, we'll be having ample amount of configuration from AWS side. Okay, now if I scroll up onto the screen, okay, again there's a decreasing in configuration. I have 16, 8 GB, 4 GB, and right away I'm back at 1 GB. Okay. Right. Okay. So what I'm selecting at step two, I'm selecting my RAM of my server. Okay. So I'll write the same thing what I'm doing at step two. Step two, I'm selecting RAM. Now moving next. If I click on next, I'll be moving to step three, and at step three, it's asking me to configure instance details. This is a very important step while we create any server. Why? Because it's asking me over here that how many number of machines do I require? How many number of machines should I create? So for example, if you want to create 5 machines in a single go, you can just specify 5 as a number over there. If you want to create 8 machines in a single go, you can specify 8 as a number over there. If you want to specify 10 machines in a single go, you can easily say 10 as a number. So what it is doing at step 3? Step 3, we are applying a bit of automation over here. How we are applying automation? In same 7 steps, you are creating multiple machines. You are creating multiple servers. You are not doing 7 steps multiple times, but rather the same 7 steps, you are creating multiple machines. So I am applying a bit of automation over here, and what I am telling, please create 2 servers for me. I have specified 2 as a number. And the next very important thing on this step 3 is the network. Now network to my machine is being provided by VPC. As of now, just keep in mind, network to my server is being provided by VPC, where VPC stands for virtual private cloud. Just assume whatever devices you people have logged in with, either mobile or a laptop, you have connected to some network, right? To your Wi-Fi router or mobile network, right? So that device is connected to that particular Wi-Fi or mobile network. Similarly, over here in cloud, my server is connected to virtual private cloud, which is nothing but VPC.
Sir, sorry to disturb you. Screen is not clearly visible, sir. Can you please zoom in once? Okay, sir. Thank you.
I got it.
Yes, sir.
And then moving ahead from I'll go back to step one. If your guide has any problem on the screen part, So basically, we are trying to create a server with these 7 steps, right? So at step one, what we are doing? We are choosing an AMI, nothing but machine image, Amazon machine image, nothing but you are selecting your machine operating system, your server operating system. So we have list of operating systems. We have Linux operating system. We have Windows operating system. We have SUSE. We have lot many operating systems provided by AWS to us. All are licensed and trademarked. So I have selected Windows at step one. Selected. Now I have moved on to step two. Step two, I was selecting machine RAM. Size of my RAM. Configuration of my RAM. So I have selected 1 GB of RAM. So you can see if I scroll down, there are different RAM configurations given to me. And the maximum RAM you can take for a single machine, is around 12,000 GB. If you see over here, it is 12,288 GB of RAM which you can take for a single server. So we have 9,000 GB also, we have 6,000 GB also. For a single machine, I'm talking about this. For a single machine, you can take up to 12,000 GB of RAM. But that much configuration is not required for us for today's session. That's why I'm going with 1 GB of RAM. But do remember what we are doing at step two. I'm selecting my machine RAM. Configuration of my RAM. Then moving to step three. Configure instance details. What I am doing, I am specifying that how many number of machines I want, how many number of servers I want. So I have defined over here as 2, which means I want to create 2 servers. That's why I have given 2 as a number over here. And the next important thing in step 3 is network. Network to this server is being provided by VPC. is nothing but virtual private cloud. Okay, so even network is also being provided by AWS only. Okay, we don't need to be bothered about how the networking bandwidth speed will be working on. Okay, it will be very good with help of VPC. Okay, so two important things at step three. One is number of machines and the next is the network. Okay, now moving to next step. Next step is step four. Step four, it is where I will be adding storage to my machine. Okay, nothing but adding volume to my machine, or you can even say adding hard disk to my server in simple terms. Okay, so over here I have given a size as 30 GB, which means hard disk of this machine or the volume of this machine would be 30 GB. If you feel that 30 GB is not enough, you can change it to 50 GB. If you feel that 50 is not enough, you can change it to 100 GB. So what is the maximum size you can take over here? The maximum size you can take is 16.3 TB, which is nearly to 16,000 GB. Okay, which is again a very huge size. Okay, if you feel that 16,000 GB is also not enough for you, you can add one more volume of 16,000 GB. If you feel still that is not good enough for you, you can add one more 16,000 GB, one more 16,000 GB. You can go on adding up volumes or space or storage to our machine. Okay, there will not be any issue from AWS side regarding the storage. Okay, so what we are doing at step four? At step four, you are adding storage to your machine. Okay, nothing but the hard disk. Okay, and size I will go with 50 GB, so I have added it to 50 GB. Okay, and the next step is the fifth step. Fifth step is for adding tags. Okay, adding tags is also very important, because whatever machine you will create, you have to give a name to that machine. Okay, suppose there are 80 machines in your dashboard, suppose there are 80 servers, how will you identify your server out of those 80 servers? By giving name to it, right? So the same thing I will do over here. I will give a name to my server, so that if there are 80 servers in my dashboard, I should easily identify my server. Okay, so how to give a tag? You have to click on add tag, and you can say name and the value. Okay, and the value you can say, this is my Windows server. Okay, this is the way you can give a name to your server at step 5. But if you feel, if you think that I will not give a name over here, if you haven't decided with any name onto this machine, onto this server, if you don't want to give name over here at the step 5, don't give over here. It's not compulsory that you should give a name over here. The best part of AWS and the best part of cloud is you can do configuration changes on your machine at any point of time. Okay, which means what I'm trying to tell is, you can do any changes on your server, either it's a configuration level, or if you want to change the name, you want to change the storage, if you want to change the RAM, you can do any kind of changes on your server because it is a cloud server without any downtime. So there is no need to shut down the machine. On a running machine only, you can do all these changes. Okay, I will show you guys when I start this machine. I will not give a name over here at the fifth step. Rather, I will give a name when my machine is in running state. Okay, so that you guys can also see that it is how easy to change the configuration over here in AWS. Okay, so that is what the fifth step tells us to please give a name. So I will give a name once the machine starts. Okay, now at the next step is the sixth step, where it is asking me to please configure security group. Okay. So in simple terms, security group is nothing but a firewall of my machine. Okay, it will be kind of a firewall for my machine. Okay, so what does a firewall will do? Firewall will protect your machine from unwanted traffic. Okay, this security group also will give us security, so that unknown person should not log into our machine. There should be, okay, no unknown hackers or no unknown traffic should be allowed to my machine. Okay, so security group will make sure that my machine is in good security, is in good state, and it will not allow any other networks or any other, okay, guys to log in into my network. Okay, to log in into my machine. Okay, so currently if you observe, Okay, I have only enabled RDP. Okay, this is the RDP. Okay, RDP protocol. So I have only enabled, means this only protocol will be allowed to my machine. Apart from that, no other protocols will be allowed to my machine. Why I am enabling only RDP? Because as I am creating a Windows server, I want to log into that server. So whenever if you want to connect from one Windows machine to another Windows machine, we use RDP protocol, which works on port number 3389. Okay, it's a standard protocol to connect from one Windows machine to another Windows machine. Okay, so when I create this machine, when I want to log into this machine, I will use the same protocol. That is the RDP protocol. Okay, so security group is allowing RDP protocol. Apart from that, security group is not allowing any other protocols. So very secure. Okay, my machine is very secure. Okay, now moving on to the next step is the seventh step, which is the last step. Okay, seventh step is nothing but a review. Okay, you will not be selecting any configuration over here. You will just have a glance at what you have selected from step 1 to step 6. You will just check out that what you have selected from step 1 to step 6. Okay, so step 1, you have selected a Windows server. How much RAM do you have selected? You have selected 1 GB of RAM. What protocol you are enabling? You are enabling RDP protocol. What is the storage of this machine? 50 GB. Okay, the same configuration thing which I have given. Okay, showing the same things at 7th step. This is nothing but a review. Okay, so after selecting all these things, my configuration is ready with me. Now I will create a server with this configuration. For to do that, you have to click on launch. So when I click on launch, okay, it is asking me to create a key pair. Okay, why key pair is required? Okay, to log in into this machine, I require a key pair. Okay, basically to log in into any machine, we require a username and password. Okay, so username is standard over here, it is common with administrator with capital A is the username. Okay, but password is protected in this key file. Password is protected in this key pair. Okay, so password given by AWS will be very much protected. It will be encrypted password. Okay, I will show how encrypted password looks like. Okay, so let me give a name to this key pair. I'm giving it as demo, and I will download this key pair. So once the key pair is downloaded, I can create the server. I will click on launch instance. Now your server is getting created. Okay, and when I click on view instance, it will show that there are two machines which are getting ready. You can see both the machines are getting initialized. As I have selected two machines, that's why it is creating two servers for me. This is how your servers, how it is looking like. Okay, not like that older version where you will be spread across, cables are there. Okay, LAN cables are there. So that was a different dashboard. This is now how your servers looks like in cloud. Okay, like this. Okay, now meantime, when this machine is getting ready, okay, I will show how a key pair looks like. Okay, I will show you how a protected key will look like. Okay, now can you guys see this key? Right, so this is how a protected key pair will looks like. So what AWS will do, AWS will send you the password in this key format. So it will be very difficult for you to trace the password. The password could be anything from over here to here, or the password could be anything from here to here, or the password could be anything from here to here. Okay, so that is why they are giving the password in an encrypted file, so that no one should read the password. It will be very secure. Okay, so now how will you get the password? This is an encrypted key, right? Now we have to decrypt the key. So once we decrypt the key, we will get the password out of this file. Okay, so now, okay, now as you can see that we have created two servers. Both the servers are in running state. Okay, as I've told you, I will give a name to these servers when my server starts running. Now my server is in running state. Now I will give a name to this server. Okay, I will give Windows 1 to this server. Okay, and I will give Windows 2 to this machine, the second machine. Okay, now at later on, if you want to again change the name of these servers, you can easily do it. See, as I have told you, whatever changes you will be doing on this machine, your machine will not go down, your machine will not shut down. See, still it is in running state only. Okay, it is still in running state. That is the benefit of AWS cloud. That is the benefit of cloud, that whatever changes you do on these machines, okay, machines will not go down. See, if I want to change the name from Windows 1, I will give this name as Server 1. Even though I am changing the name, the server will not go down. Okay, that is one. Okay, so now these two machines are getting ready. These two servers are ready. Okay, these are Windows servers. These are Windows machines. Now similarly, I want to create one more machine. Okay, okay. So now this time I will create a Linux machine. Windows I have already created. Now I will create a Linux machine. As I have told you, whatever machine you are creating, you will be having these 7 steps as common for you. These 7 steps are universal for us. Whatever machine you create, either Linux or Windows, these 7 steps are common. Okay, so knowing these 7 steps is more important. Okay, now for creating a Linux machine, I will select a Linux image. So this is my Linux image. For step 1, I need to select an image, right? So I am selecting a Linux image. Selected. So steps are same, but configuration, I am selecting a different configuration now. Okay, step 2, I have to select machine RAM. So again, I am selecting 1 GB of RAM. This is for Linux machine. Step 2, what I am selecting? Machine RAM. Okay, next as a second, third step. Okay, see, if you see, all the steps are same only, right? Steps are same, but this time I am creating a Linux machine. Okay, step 2, step 3. Okay, how many number of machines should I create? If I want to create one, I will give as 1. Okay, and next at step 4, what should I do? I have to add storage at step 4. Because it is a Linux machine, it is going with 8 GB of storage. It will not consume a lot of storage, because Linux machine doesn't consume a lot of storage. That's why it's going with 8 GB of storage. Okay, so step 4, the same, adding storage. Okay, step 5, I will giving tags to my machine, but I will not add any tag set over here. I will add tags when my machine starts running. Okay, now at step 6, same regarding security group, it will provide a firewall, it will provide a security to my Linux machine. So if you remember, at Windows Server when we created, it was using RDP protocol, remote desktop protocol. But as now I have created a Linux machine, it is using SSH protocol. Why? Because to connect to a Linux machine, I require SSH protocol. That's why it is using SSH protocol. It is only allowing SSH protocol. Okay. Now when I click on next, this is the last step. 7th step is a review. So now it is showing you what you have selected. Now you have selected a Linux image, 1 GB of RAM. How much is the storage? 8 GB is the storage. Okay. Now if I click on launch, again it will ask me for a key pair. I will use the demo key pair. I will click on launch. Now Linux machine is also getting created. See. Now how many servers are there on your dashboard? There are 3 servers. 2 are Windows and 1 is Linux. Okay. And I will give a name to this Linux machine. I will click over here and I will say this is a Linux machine. Okay. So whatever machine you are creating, 7 steps are common. Okay. See, now I have created a Windows machines as well as I have created a Linux machine also. Okay. Now let us log in to Windows machine. Let us log in and check that the machine which we have created is running fine or not. Okay. So how to log in to this Windows machine? We have to select the Windows machine. We have to click on connect. So once you click on connect, okay, it will ask you to download a file. Please download that file. Okay. Now to log in into that machine, what do we require? We require a username and password. Okay, not only into cloud machine, for any machine, either your desktop or a laptop, it could be any machine. To log into that machine, you require a username and password, right? So username, as I have told you, username is common, universal is, it is universally common, administrator with a capital A, right? But password is an encrypted file. Password is a protected password. Okay, so how to get password? Click on get password. Okay, choose this key pair which you have downloaded, the demo file, the encrypted file. We have to select that encrypted file. Okay, once I choose that encrypted file, my encrypted file is over here. Now you can see that it got selected. right? So this is the encrypted file. Password is somewhere in between this file. How to get the password? Now if you click on decrypt password, it will show you the password. So this is the password of your machine now. Okay, you can log in into this machine with the help of this password. Okay, so now I will copy this password. I will close this screen. Okay, I will click over here to connect to that machine. I will click on connect. Okay, I will open this part. Okay, I will give username is the administrator. I will give the password. I have pasted the password. This is my password. And now when I click on okay, okay, now it is trying to connect to that machine. I will show you how it is connecting. She is asking me to connect to that machine. I will click on yes, please connect. Okay. Now again, I will show you what is the next screen. See, it is trying to establish a connection. Okay. Now I will show how it is logged into that machine. Okay. Okay. Now it is trying to log into that machine. Okay. Don't worry. It will show us a desktop icons now. It is loading the screen. So now you guys can see this is the Windows machine which I have created in AWS Cloud. Okay, this is the Windows machine which I have created. Okay, this is not my laptop. Okay, this is not my laptop. This is the server which I have created in Cloud. Okay, now let us check this machine configuration. Okay, if I go over here and if I want to check this machine configuration which I have created in Cloud, you can see the storage, the volume, how it is showing. It is showing 50 GB. I have selected same 50 GB. That is the reason it is showing the same 50 GB as my storage size. Okay, now if I want to check this machine RAM, if I go to properties, okay, it will show me the RAM size of this machine. So now you can see that this machine is running on 1 GB of RAM. Okay, now I can use this machine in any way possible. I can use this machine as a server, I can use this machine as my laptop, or I can use this machine as a personal machine also. Okay, but I haven't, okay, paid anything for creating this machine until now. Okay. But, okay, that is why AWS is becoming so popular. See, now if a company wants to have this machine as a desktop or a server for them, okay, they need to pay at least 10 to 15K. If they want to purchase it from the market, they have to spend at least 15K to 20K, the basic amount I am telling. Okay, even though they might not get the machine with that price, let us assume for 15K or 20K, if they are getting this machine from a market, rather than getting it from market, if I get it from AWS, it is so less cost for me over here. They will give me the same storage, same RAM size. Okay, they will give me even more security because security group is also there. If they are giving me so many things without spending much, rather than getting the machine from market, attaching hardware, attaching monitor, attaching hard disk, attaching everything by myself, they are giving me machine ready to use. Okay, it is ready to use for me. So then why I will get it from market? So that is why what companies are doing. That is the reason companies are getting the machines from AWS. They are more secure. You can create any machine. Okay, you can get whatever storage you want. And not only that, if you want to change this storage from 50 GB to 100 GB, you can easily do it over here. If you want to do it physically, you have to purchase more hard disk for your machine. You have to purchase more storage. But over here, you can simply increase the storage. Okay. Now coming to the network of this machine, either, okay, network is provided to this machine or not. Let us check in the browser. Okay. Now on this browser, okay, if I give any website link, okay, let us open, okay, Yahoo. Okay. Now if you see that it is establishing a connection or not, okay, see, it is loading a web page, which means network is working on this machine. Okay, internet is actually working on this machine. I haven't paid for internet also. AWS is also providing me the internet to this machine. Okay, if it was a physical machine, I have to connect LAN or I have to connect Wi-Fi to this machine. But it is also not required. AWS is giving me all these facilities. It is also giving me network to this machine. Okay, and if you closely observe, this Yahoo page, if you see, this is a US Yahoo page. Okay, why it is showing a US Yahoo page? because the server which I have created, it is in US region. This server is actually running in US region. Okay, that is the reason you are seeing Yahoo page. Okay, so being sitting at your home or being sitting in whichever location you are, you can create servers in any part of the globe. You can create servers in US, UK, Canada, Australia, any part of the world you can create. Steps are same. You have to use those 7 steps only for creating any kind of machine or in any part of the globe. Those 7 steps will remain common for you. Okay, so that is why these many benefits are given by AWS. That is why companies are going behind AWS. That is why it is trending so much. Okay, now coming back to AWS screen again. Okay, see, 2 Windows servers I have created and I have created 1 Linux server as well. Okay, now let us connect to this Linux machine also. Okay, now how to connect to that Linux machine? Okay, you require 1 additional software for that, that is PuTTY. Okay, if you don't want to log in from PuTTY, we have 1 more way of logging to that machine. Okay, through command line mode. Okay, so what I suggest you guys to be working more on command line mode. Okay, why? Because in real time, most of the scenarios you will be using Linux machines only. Even in our sessions also, I will be making sure that we will be working on more and more on Linux machines only, because in real time environment you will be working on more on Linux machines only. Now let us log into Linux machine also and let us check, okay, how we need to log into Linux machine. I will share that part of screen as well now. Okay, now I think you guys can see the command line mode of my machine. Okay, now to log into Linux machine, okay, the command is ssh hyphen I, okay, the location of my key file, the location of my key file is this, okay, and the name of my key file is demo.pem. So I'm giving the same name for my file, the demo.pem. Once again, screen will be back once again. Okay, I hope you are getting my screen again on CLI. Yes. Okay, so the name of my key file, okay, and the username to log into my Linux machine is ec2-user, and I have to give the IP address of my Linux machine. Okay, so when I hit enter, it will ask me, should I connect to that machine? I will say yes, please connect to that machine. Okay, it is establishing a connection. Okay, and you can see that I have successfully connected to my Linux machine, which is in AWS cloud. Okay, so how we check the configuration for Windows machine? Let us check the configuration of this Linux machine also. To check the storage of Linux machine, the command is df space hyphen h. If you enter this command, it will show you what is the available storage on your Linux machine. So if you remember that I have taken 8 GB as the hard disk for Linux machine. Out of 8 GB, 1.5 GB is used and 6.6 GB is free to utilize. Okay, which means 6.6 GB is available to use. Okay, this was about the storage. Okay, if you want to check RAM, command is free hyphen m. Okay, and it will show you the RAM size. It is showing 983 MB, which means it's nearly to 1 GB. I have selected say 1 GB of RAM. It is showing me the same 1 GB of RAM size. Okay, so you can see that I have created multiple machines on the same dashboard. I have created Windows, I have logged into Windows, and then I have created a Linux machine, and then I have logged into Linux machine as well. Okay, so these many advantages. You can create any machine, any part of the world, either maybe Windows or Linux, anything. Okay, even the steps, they have simplified it so much. Okay, you only require 7 steps for creating any kind of a machine. Okay, yes, right. Okay, now, okay, if you have any questions or doubts, you can please go ahead and ask me. Yes guys, can you hear me now clearly? Okay, yes. So Utkarsh has given a question in the chat. Okay, that do we need to pay it on monthly basis or yearly basis? Okay, so we need to pay on monthly basis. Utkarsh, the monthly bill from AWS will be given to us on a monthly basis. And the other question is, what's the difference if you are running it on physically or if you are running it on cloud? So if you want to run it on physically, you have to pay a bit much more than which you are running it on cloud. Okay. So if you are running the machines on AWS cloud, you will be getting more security, more reliability. Whatever configuration changes we'll be doing on AWS machine, you will not be having any downtime. So with these many advantages and getting a bit of cost less for those servers, so running it on cloud is more beneficial than running it on physical. Okay. I hope it got answered. And one more question we have from Praveen S. Praveen is asking that AWS will be covered first, okay, and then AWS will be covered in later part of our session. Yes, Praveen. Okay, Linux and AWS will be covered at first term of our course. Okay, why? Because Linux is also very important. I don't want to miss out any Linux concepts when we are going ahead with AWS, because I will be covering most of the AWS on Linux servers only. Because in real time also you will be having Linux servers only to work on mostly. So we'll be covering Linux and AWS at the first quarter of our term. And then we'll be moving on to DevOps and DevOps tools. In that way, you will be understanding things much more clear. Okay. So we'll try to learn AWS and Linux, and then we'll try to implement DevOps tools on those Linux and AWS platform.
Hello, sir.
Yes, please.
Am I audible?
Yes, 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 please.
Sir, my project building from the Microsoft, right?
Okay.
Windows server, right? So can I create the server on Linux?
You can definitely create a server on Linux. Okay. If you are using Microsoft Cloud, then it is a Microsoft Azure Cloud.
Hmm.
Okay. On Azure Cloud also, you can create a Linux machine.
Okay. Okay. So by default, yes. Linux will be provided which database?
Linux will be giving you MySQL database, and Maria database is being given from Linux machine.
Okay. And Windows?
Okay. On to Windows, we have Microsoft MySQL, MS SQL of Microsoft on Windows. Okay. MS we will not be getting MariaDB on Windows. We have to install explicitly.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yes. Yes, guys, please, you can give questions in chat, or you can just unmute and ask also. Okay. So Kirti is asking regarding live projects. Okay. After the course. Yes, Kirti. Okay. But we'll be doing live projects during the course only. Okay. I don't want to go ahead with live projects after the course. In that way, we'll not be learning much. So whenever we are doing concepts, whenever we are going with through our sessions, okay, we'll be going with three projects during this whole course duration. Okay, on AWS, on DevOps tools, on Kubernetes stuffs, we'll be doing these projects. I will show you on our live sessions. I will show how we are doing these projects, how we are doing Hello. This. Okay, how we are using these tools. Sir. Yes, yes, please.
Sir, I want to more information about your syllabus. We celebrate DevOps and Jenkins, you know, life cycle. So yes. Can you provide the syllabus of that courses?
Yes, course content will be, okay, course content will be forwarded to you guys through mail and WhatsApp also. But I will just brief you that what things we'll be covering. Okay, on DevOps side, we'll be covering CI/CD for Jenkins. Okay, we'll be covering Terraform. Terraform is very important, and Terraform is trending a lot nowadays, because industry, there are a lot of DevOps opportunities are there, but DevOps guys are not, it's like Terraform. Terraform opportunities are, a lot of opportunities are there on Terraform. Okay,
okay.
So Terraform is very advanced infrastructure as a code, okay, tool, okay, where we need to write scripts. So as now we have created these three servers, right? Manually. Yes. Instead of creating it manually, I will show how to create from Terraform script. Okay. Yes. So we'll be covering Terraform. We'll be covering Kubernetes, Docker, Docker tools, Maven. Okay.
Okay. Sir,
yes.
Sir, one question.
Yes, please.
I learn your course. After then, can I apply the exam of the AWS cloud?
AWS. Yes, exactly. Once you complete this course, you people can go for AWS certification also. Okay. Certification, again, there are two types of certification. One is associate level and the other is professional level. Okay. At associate level also, you have solution architect. Okay. So once you complete solution architect at professional level, you can go for DevOps professional certification. Okay. If you guys are much more interested towards certification also, okay, our guys will help you. At least if you are much more keen interested, I will suggest that please go for associate level. Okay. Then professional level, once you enter into the company, okay, try to do from your company end, then the company will pay for that certification.
But sir, entirely cloud-based server, it will be freely.
It will not be entirely free, but whatever account you will create, okay, I will help how to create an AWS account. That account will be free, and you can create servers, you can create database, you can create storage on that account without any cost.
Sir, one question. Because my client is Kuwait, so can I create the server and AWS, right? Na?
Yes. You can easily create and happily create server on AWS.
Just you show this type of the application, I can use, and I can create the server, right?
Yes, exactly. You can create the server.
Sir, once I create the server, how can I use it, my current project?
Okay. You can use for whatever application you want. You have to just deploy your application code onto that server. How will you connect to that server? For Windows, as I've shown you, there is a connect option. For Linux, you have to communicate through IP of that machine. Okay. You have to take IPs of that machine. You have to deploy your application, which means you have to install your application. Okay. Whatever application you want to give to your client, you have to just apply.
Okay.
So it is a banking application or e-commerce application. What application you are working on?
Banking application.
Banking application only. Okay. Then AWS will be very good, because rather than Azure and GCP, you will have more security on AWS cloud.
Okay.
Hi, sir. Praveen here.
Yes, Praveen.
Yeah, I have a few questions. So my first question is, so what will be the duration of this course, both AWS and DevOps?
Yes. So Linux, AWS and DevOps, complete course duration is 50 days,
50 days. Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. And my second doubt is, in DevOps, in which language you are implementing? So
DevOps, Terraform. Terraform is the scripting language which we
are using. Okay, scripting language we are using, right?
Yes. Okay. And please do research on Terraform. Okay. Terraform, and upcoming 1 to 2 years, Terraform will be ruling the market. Like how AWS is currently trending in market now. Upcoming 1 to 2 years. Okay.
Okay.
Terraform will be also ruling the market.
Okay, so can we integrate Terraform with the programming languages? Because if some project is developed on Java or Python, so can we integrate Terraform with these languages?
Yes, definitely. You can easily integrate it with Java, Python. Even for microservices also, you can easily integrate Terraform. Okay, and not only on AWS, you can use Terraform on AWS, Google Cloud and Microsoft Cloud also.
Yeah, okay. And for professionals and working experience, who can join for this course?
Freshers and working guys can please join for this one. Okay, because earlier, we had students who were working on Java technology since 8 years. Now they are shifting to DevOps.
Okay.
So why they are now shifting to DevOps is because there are more opportunities, there is a better pay scale, right? And you have very good things to learn on DevOps side. So they were working as Java professionals since 8 years, now they are moving to DevOps. So coming to freshers, if they start their career now as a DevOps side, so by the time they move to team lead or the managers, it will be more good for them.
Okay.
Right. They no need to shift from DevOps to any other stream.
Okay.
sir, fees kit, how much sir fees?
Okay, yes, okay, our people will send you the course content and fees details also.
Okay,
yes. Shiva Kumar is asking one question. He's asking, can admins can learn this course? Yes, definitely, Shiva Kumar. Okay, it will be very beneficial for, especially for admins. Okay, why? Because now physical infrastructure, okay, is going very less. No company wants to use physical servers. All, most of the companies wants to use cloud servers only, because there are very flexible servers and very secure and very reliable. Especially for admins, it is a high time you should move to DevOps side, because there will be no network admin and there will be no system admin jobs in future. Okay, please don't worry that I am telling this thing. I am actually being very frank. Okay, it's a high time, because when you come to DevOps and DevOps sites, they are actually reducing the number of admins. They want more DevOps engineers.
Yeah, can we get the recorded session on the course?
Yes, yes, definitely. The session is recorded and every session will be recorded. Okay. And you guys will be getting all the recordings onto your email IDs. So what I suggest is, after every class, whenever I will be pressure on more on practice. So after every session, there will be a recording to you. Please go through that recording and please try to do that practice based on the recordings.
Okay, and daily one hour.
Whatever I am, yes, daily. Yes, daily 6 to 7. Whatever I am doing daily, whatever I am creating, whatever I am doing on the screen, please try to do that in your practice session.
Okay. So Saturday, Sunday also classes there, or Saturday, Sunday as well?
Sunday there will be leave. Saturday we will be having. Okay.
Yeah.
Only Sunday there will be talk.
And Pravin.
Yeah. Thanks.
Hi. Hello.
Yes. Yes. Srinivas. Yes.
Hi, sir. Hi, sir. Good evening.
Yes,
actually, I don't know anything about this DevOps and AWS, all the things. Can I join, sir? Can I eligible for this one?
Yes, yes, yes. Sure, sure. So, what is your background, Silver? Java. Are you working on a fresher?
Java, sir.
Java. You are working on Java.
Yes, sir.
Okay, then that is a very good thing. If you already have some of the programming knowledge, that will also benefit a lot. But if you are a fresher also, please don't worry. I will be teaching from step one, from scratch. Okay.
But some guys are saying that AWS is separate, DevOps is separate, like that saying, sir. I have a little bit doubt actually. But
yes,
what are the AWS content entire will be teach, or apart from only how much using in our AWS, that's part only you are teaching to AWS, sir?
Okay. No, no. See, all the real-time environment things I'll be teaching regarding AWS. Okay. So today what we did, you know, whatever we did today, this will be your first task. When you go on the floor, when you go to a company, when you start doing a job on AWS, okay, your team lead or your manager will tell you to do the same thing, as if they might tell you to please create a server. So the same thing we did today. So these kind of tasks, okay, these kind of things, how a team lead or a manager will tell us, we will be covering same kind of things through curriculum. So it will be then a real-time approach to you. Later on, if there will be interview, and if somebody in interview asks you that how you created storage and how you created servers, means these were the steps you have to tell, that these are the steps how I created a machine.
But how about integrating our Java application to this DevOps related build and deployment these are all showing now, sir.
Yes. So there is a special tool for a deployment. Okay. Oh. For that, which we'll be using Jenkins. So using Jenkins, yes, you can, using Jenkins, you can deploy your Java application onto this machines, onto this server. Okay. So AWS and DevOps are separate only. Okay. AWS and DevOps are separate. But how they will work, if for a company, you have to integrate AWS and DevOps and you have to work
along with our Java code, sir.
Okay, and then if you are working as a DevOps engineer, then you will not be working on Java code.
Java code, okay.
Yes. Okay, Java as a programming language will never be used for DevOps.
Okay.
Okay.
But integration point of view, are you showing now, sir?
Yes, integration point of view, we'll be using Jenkins. Not only Java application, you can install microservice application any application can be deployed on any cloud server through Jenkins.
Sir, total Docker, Kubernetes, all the things covered, no, sir?
Yes, definitely. Docker is covered, Kubernetes is covered.
But AWS fully covered, no, sir?
Yes. AWS fully covered with live examples, with live sessions.
But yeah, another one important, sir, if you don't mind.
Yes.
I don't know any Linux command, sir. Don't know ABCD is also in Linux.
Yes. So that is why when I do these sessions, no, whatever command I use, I will clearly explain that why we are using this command and what is the purpose of that command.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Because Linux is very important, and please don't worry. We will be starting from Linux, AWS, and then to DevOps.
Okay, sir. Are you giving that much of assurance? I can surely join, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yes. Okay. From Linux only we'll start. Definitely.
Yeah. Are you
then, sir, how many working days, sir? How many working days?
Okay. 50 working days.
50.
Yeah. 50.
Total AWS and DevOps.
Yes. Total AWS and DevOps. And every day there will be 1 hour of session. Sometimes it might go to 1 to 1.5 hour also.
Depends upon concept.
Yeah, depends upon concept.
Yeah, are you covering LK stack also?
LK stack also, yes. Elastic, load, okay. And Kibana.
Yeah, okay.
That is a part of DevOps, Sandeep.
Yeah, thanks.
Yes. Hello, sir. Yes, please.
Hello. Sir, Karthik is here.
Okay, yes, sir.
Hello. Sir, currently I'm working in services team. I don't know any, I'm not having any knowledge about the programming and all those things. So, it is eligible for me, sir.
Yes. Okay. So, which services you are working on?
Service desk team means it is an, related to admin, administrator as well as for IT support.
Okay. So you are working as kind of a IT and admin support.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So currently your servers on physically running?
Yes, sir. I mean initial stages of administrator.
Yes. See now when you move ahead in your career or when you move to your next step of your career, you have to move to cloud only.
Okay.
Now what you are working is at previous generation technology which you are working on. Yes, so the next upcoming thing where you have to move is cloud one.
Yes, sir. Okay. So.
Yes. Okay. So now Utkarsh has given. And Utkarsh has given one location. I'm currently in a university from cloud computing background where we used to study about clouds and AWS. Is this course beneficial? Okay. I'm a fresher. Definitely, Utkarsh. Why? Because see, when you are starting your career as a fresher, now experienced guys are moving to DevOps side. Experienced guys who have already worked in industry for 4 to 5 years, they are moving to DevOps side. So if you start your career from a DevOps side, by the time you become team lead or by the time you become senior in the team, it will be very good and very beneficial for you. So people are moving now to DevOps. You are starting your career only with DevOps, so that will be a more advantage, right?
So can we install our own standalone application in AWS machine, Windows machine, sir?
Yes. You can install it. Definitely, you can install it. Whatever is the software or application which you run on physical machine, no, you can install any kind of software or application on cloud machine also.
Okay. Hi, sir. One more thing. You said we have to use PuTTY to access Linux machine, right?
Yes.
It can be used FileZilla instead, because I have some knowledge in FileZilla.
Yes. You can use FileZilla also, you can use PuTTY, you can use Super PuTTY also, or else you can use PowerShell or simple command line also you can use.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, yes.
Hi, sir.
Yes, sir,
do you suggest 4 years of a Java developer?
Yes.
To switch into the DevOps or AWS?
Yes, definitely. See, I will tell one thing to you guys. Okay, on AWS and DevOps side, there are two things. One is the administrator part, and the other is operations part. Okay, or else again in simple words, I will tell you there is a development part and there is operations part. So whoever who are coming from programming side, they can go for development side because they already have some programming knowledge. It will benefit for them when they are going for development side of cloud. Okay, development side of AWS. And whoever having admin experience, okay, administration experience or freshers, okay, they can move on operation side of cloud. So operation side of cloud, you will not be having much programming. Most of the things you have to automate there. That is automation side of cloud. What about the development side of cloud? If you have a programming knowledge, very good programming knowledge, you can implement Terraform, you can implement Python, these kind of programming languages you can implement. Okay? So it is beneficial for both the kind of people. Either if you are from development side, yes, you can do that also. If you are not from development side and if you don't want to do programming, you can work on operation side of DevOps. That's why it is DevOps, which means development plus operations.
Yeah, okay, got it. Thank you.
Yes. Okay, guys, then, okay, it was very good talking to you, okay, and, okay, sharing the things, and, okay, thanks a lot for your time, okay, please yes, do sir. Take care.
Yeah, sir, I have one more doubt. Yeah,
yes,
one more
please.
Last doubt.
Yes, please.
Yeah, so tomorrow also demo class will be there, right? So, how many demo classes are there?
Okay, tomorrow is like there will be demo class, but today we were on the task one, right? Tomorrow we will be on task two.
Okay.
Okay, we'll be doing the second task.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, thanks.
Okay, yes, please. Okay, there is one more question. Okay, I'll take as the last question. And okay, so the question is what will be your day to day activities in cloud? Okay, so he's already been doing, okay, working on Java as a backend. Okay, don't have any knowledge on Linux. Okay, no problem. We'll be starting, okay, from Linux only because I told you I don't want to mix Linux because if you are missing Linux, you are missing the basic things. Okay, so we'll be starting from basics. We'll be starting from Linux. Okay, so the day-to-day jobs of a cloud engineer will be, okay, as we have created these machines right today, you have to maintain these machines, you have to manage these machines. If there are any configuration changes which you have to do on these machines, you have to do. Suppose increasing the storage, decreasing the storage. So whatever you will be doing, you have to do it in an automated way. Okay, that will be your day-to-day task. And deploying the code, deploying the application on your server, that will be your job only as a DevOps engineer. Okay. Okay, so role wise and work wise, you will be spread across multiple sites. Okay. You will be having a lot of things to do. Your day will be whole packed anyhow. Okay. Yes. Okay. Okay. But okay, do search for Terraform also. Okay, because it's very, very much leading. Okay. Okay then, thanks. Okay, take care guys, thanks a lot for the time.
Yeah, thanks sir, bye.
Yes, sir. Bye.